And starting with the big story that we are tracking in the huge win for the enforcement directorate, Vijay Mallya has now been declared a fugitive economic offender by a special court in Mumbai. With this, Mallya now becomes the first person to be termed a fugitive under the newly passed Fugitive Economic Offenders Act. Mallya's properties in Karnataka and in the United Kingdom can now be confiscated by the government.
What would you say on the judgment? A beef?
I don't know. I've not received a copy.
Sir, but you were then the court when the court pronounced its orders?
All that the court said is he declared an offender. That's all.
So, sir, you were seeking some time to appeal in the High Court, but the time was not given. What was the reason for the court for not giving extra time for this?
They don't have the power to grant stay.
So, sir, will you appeal in High Court?
Let us see the judgment.
Because they have declared an offender, that's why their all assets are... हमारी गवर्नमेंट ओवरटेक करके बेच के डेट्स क्लियर कर सकती है हमें सिर्फ ये उम्मीद है कि अब गवर्नमेंट सिर्फ अपने एसेट्स ना देखें यानी कि पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स बल्कि उसका ह्यूमन कॉस्ट देखे इस पूरे मिस इवेंट का क्योंकि एम्प्लॉयज़ जिन को इतने टाइम से सैलरी नहीं मिली है उनके ड्यूज भी क्लियर करने चाहिए
Let's go across to Disha, who's joining me at this point. Disha, this is, of course, the Enforcement Directorate has been wanting this to have Vijay Mallya declared. And this is now means that his assets will all now be able to get seized.
Well, absolutely, that's right. And he's the first tycoon, like you rightly pointed out, to be declared as the fugitive economic offender under the new act, which was recently passed in the parliament. And now, of course, this new law allows the government to confiscate all his properties. And again, like you pointed out, in UK and Karnataka and all the other places possible. We know for the fact that it was just last year in the month of December where he had said that he is willing to return all the money and the UK court had ordered his extradition back to India and that is where of course now this entire process really started off and this is the first time ever that such an order has been passed by the special PMLA court here in the city of Mumbai. In fact, we know for the fact that this law was made for the people like Vijay Mallya and also for Mehul Choksi and Nirav Modi who or on the run with money from the public banks with a tune of about over 100 crore rupees. And this stringent law was in need of an hour. And we know for the fact that ED also had filed an application in the court demanding that he should be declared as a fugitive economic offender under the new act. So here, this entire decision by the special PMLA court has really acted as a mere significant because this also will act as a crackdown for people like Mehul Choksi and others who have the similar amount of money taken from the public banks and not really returned back. So this, of course, is a big win for the ED as well, like you rightly pointed out. But tune of about over 100 crore rupees and that is why this stringent law comes into place and last year in the month of December the UK court had ordered his extradition and that is why now we know for the fact that he is the first tycoon to be declared fugitive economic offender under the new act which was passed recently in the parliament.
All right, thanks Disha for getting us all those details.